And always make you feel loved.
To stick together
through thick and thin.
To be your rock.
And to hold you together when you fall apart.
To believe in each other.
To believe in our children.
Together we are a family.
And together we make our house a home.
I promise not to buy any more apartments without you.
And I promise to stop going on about it.
I will occasionally let you sleep in.
And sometimes I'll wake up without your prompting.
I'll keep baking for you.
And I'll try not to eat too many of your creations. I'll keep cooking for you.
And I'll carry on cleaning up afterwards. I promise not to force you to run in races.
But I'll always be at your finish line.
Because wherever
we end up there together.
I promise to make time for each other.
No matter what's going on.
To continue to smash you at Scrabble.
To beat you at Monopoly.
But to always keep playing.
And one day, I'll learn to spell.
I promise to keep inventing traditions.
And I'll keep the old ones going.
I'll try and learn lyrics.
And I'll sing the words you forget.
I promise to kiss you goodbye in the morning.
And snuggle up to you in the evening.
I swear not to leave you for a man.
Or another woman.
to stop and appreciate everything we are,
even though it's everything we've always been,
to listen to your opinion without fail,
and to speak up when I disagree.
I vow to cherish the truth that when I am with you,
everything is better,
and to always let you be you,
because I love you just the way you are.
To work every day to be the woman you deserve.
To work every day to be the woman you deserve.
Forever.
And always. I do.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love,
with it all that I have and all that I am.
Let it be a reminder that when I tell you I love you,
I don't say it out of habit or to make or end a conversation.
I say it because I will hold you forever in the circle of my love,
and I'm honoured to call you my wife,
and to share this life journey with you.
With my whole heart,
for my whole life,
I will be forever yours,
and your happiness will be inseparable from my own.
It's my very great pleasure to welcome everybody to the celebration of Maxine and Florence's wedding. So my mother and I miss Florence every day. You only have to see these two together to realise that they belong together. So returning to tradition for a moment, it would be traditional for me to offer a word of advice to the happy couple. But actually, in the past few years, I think that, if anything, it's the other way around. I think Florence is more able to advise me, given the experience of life that you've had, and done things which I've never done. There's maybe one thing that I hope you subconsciously learned from your mother and myself. And that's when your spouse is your best friend, that's a wonderful thing. And you have nothing to worry after that, and much joy to look forward to for the rest of your life.
So, we've all travelled a long way. I think one person in the room who's championed us all. He's 83 years old, he's sat there. Florence's grandfather. Yeah. And we really, really welcome you and your two girls. We're really proud of Maxine, both academically and personally in her achievements. She's met some fantastic people on her way through her life, certainly at university. And she sat next to a great lady in Flo next to her. You know, Flo joined us in much to Sue's heartache, I know, and Tim's heartache. Flo came over to Australia last August and joined us, and we welcomed you in. We loved you being around us, and certainly I love Flo being around because Flo is my best drinking buddy. Tim and Sue, while they're in Australia, we'll look out for them well. We love looking out for them.
So it's been mentioned already, but I'd like to thank Florence and Maxine for choosing all of us to share in their day, especially given the setting that we're in. When they first told me that they were getting married, I was quite concerned we might end up somewhere like Woking or Rugby. I equally appreciate that the venue is somewhere that was both easy to get to and cheap to attend. I've been told as well, it's traditional for me to toast the beautiful bridesmaids. They've all done brilliantly, considered they were forced into getting their dresses nearly a year early and barely a single one came in the right size. It's a glass, two. Rosie, Alexa, Beth and Abby. That time you could be forgiven for finding today a bit of a surprise. Mainly because the way that Flo began her medical school career, we weren't sure she'd be there very long. You'd have to say that Maxine spent a good 3 to 4 months terrified of Florence. But for me, their relationship began the day that Maxine's rowing career came to an untimely end due to a shoulder injury following a running race under the influence of far too much alcohol. To say that Maxine managed her injury well would be a lie. Requiring almost 24-hour care, a role which Florence was only too happy to fill, mainly as I think it gave her a valid reason to continue not going to lectures. Flo and Max are probably the most grown up of all of us now, strangely. Both with good jobs, the first to get married and even discussing when they would begin a family. I know they deserve and I wish them every happiness in the world. The only shame is that we can't all be there with you. I'd like to all raise our glasses to the bride and bride, two of my best friends, Dr. and Mrs. Borley.
Dr. and Mrs. Borley.
Longer if I can.
you. As long as the seasons need you, follow their plan. How long will I be with you? As long as the sea is bound to wash upon the sand. How long will I want you? As long as you want me to, and longer by far. How long will I hold you? As long as your father told you, as long as you can. How long will I give to you? As long as you say, how long will I love you? As long as stars are above you, and longer if I may. Above you.